Well, to get started, first we'll open up a browser and type in Flutter. Then we'll click on this link and then we'll click on Get Started. And over here we'll choose to install for Windows. Okay, and for Windows installation, there are some requirements. Well, first we have to choose the Windows version. Of course, it's more than 64-bit or later. All right, and first we have to install Git for Windows, so we'll click over here, and later on we'll choose 64-bit Git for Windows setup. Okay, all right, so we'll download it and then double click, and there are some pretty simple steps to follow. So it'll open up after double clicking, and then we'll just basically click next, next, and next. Okay, and with this, we'd be done with the setup. And along the way, we'll choose some options. And those are most of them are default options. So just go ahead and click next, next, and next. And over here, we'll finish. All right, great. And after that, we'll install Flutter for Windows. Click on this. And I have already downloaded it, so I don't want to download it. So go ahead and download for yourself. And it should be in your downloads folder and extract it. Okay? All right. And after extracting it, we see the stable version. And inside this, there is a Flutter folder. Okay? All right. So next thing we need to do, we need to put it the Flutter folder inside our C folder, okay? So what we'll do, we'll open it up and here we'll try to copy or cut actually. We'd cut it and then we'd go to C folder and put it over here. Okay, so we'll paste it. So it would be pasted over here. And then we double click it and we see that there are a lot of folders and files inside of this. All right. Okay, next thing we need. So next we need to update our environment variable path. So just type in here env and select the first option and click environment variables. And then over here you see I will choose the second one path. If you don't have it, you can go ahead and create a new one, name path and give the path name. But I have already one, so I'm not going to do that. I'll double click on it, and over here, I will go to C folder and find Flutter folder, the one I pasted. And now at the top, we see, well, now we'll go to the bin folder. Now over here, we see that there is a path for it. So we'll just go ahead and copy the path. And this path, after copying, we'll paste it over here, but create a new one first and paste it. Select OK and then OK, and after that, OK again. So, with this, we are done with setting up our environment variables. Now you can type in Flutter Doctor and we'll see some outputs. So, let's just wait for it. So, his Flutter is still checking. Yes, so it's working, but there are a few more steps to go ahead. And you see it says that Flutter stable version has been installed, but now we need to install Android Studio and Android Toolchain and a lot of other tools for development. So next we'll go ahead and install Android Studio. Click over here and it will take you to a new page and download Android Studio. Just accept the license and download it. Okay, all right. And as always, I have already did it, so I'm not going to download again. And it's over here. I'll double click on it and we'll see the pop-up installation. Okay, so I would click next, next, pretty much next over here. Not much to change. Okay, all right. So just click install. Okay, all right. And over here we'll click next again and finish. So with this, our Android Studio would pop up. It may take a bit of time for you. All right, just to click next. Okay, we'll select custom in this case, next. And pretty much next, you don't need to change anything. So you can choose the theme. I would choose Darkula and select these options. All right, just like me, those two options. And make sure the Android path is, SDK path is like that. And just use recommended. And over here we have some options, but we're not going to change them. And accept the license. And just like this, Intel license, Android SDK license, and click finish. Okay, all right. And then I'll finish again, okay. All right, so after this, we need to install some plugins. So the first plugin we want to install is Flutter. So click on the marketplace and type in Flutter. So over here, I'll click install the first one. You have to accept it. And it would want to install Dart for Flutter because they work together. So just click install. So Dart would be installed automatically. Dart, right? Okay. All right, so after that, I'll click on restart IDE. Yes, restart. Okay, great. And then let's see what else we need to install. A lot of things are already installed over here. So yeah, we are good to go. So over here, type in, find your command line and type in Flutter Doctor. And this time we'll see that Android Studio and Android Toolchain has been installed. Okay, yeah. All right, command line tools component is missing. All right, and okay, click here for more options and click here SDK manager. Okay, so here are some of the selections that we have to do for SDK tools. Okay, all right. Android SDK command line tools. Apply and do okay. So it will download some necessary SDKs from the internet, from Google server, and what else? So Google Play services, Play licensing library. These two are quite important. Go for Google USB drive as well. So yeah, just select this and click apply. Okay. And you should be good to go. Finish. Apply. Okay. Type in Flutter Doctor one more time and let's see, we'll have improvement this time. Okay, so you see Android license has been accepted, Android Studio devices and things are there. So now we have to accept the license, so it's asked us to run Flutter Doctor Android license. So just go ahead with yes, pretty much all yes, you can't really say no. Okay, one more time, Flutter Doctor. Okay, so now here we see that pretty much everything has been accepted and installed over here. Okay, and so everything is great. So now we'll create a new project, new Flutter project. So I'll click over here. You can click on new project. It's pretty much the same. But we'll just simply select Flutter new project and select Flutter over here. You need to choose SDK path. So we'll choose from here, go to the C drive and the Flutter, and pretty much that's it, because inside this we have bin. So and name it anything you want, okay, it doesn't really matter. So I'll name it hello world. So this is the most common type of name. All right, you can save it anywhere you want. Okay, so yeah, so just keep it simple like this. Okay, and these are the default settings, you don't need to change. Okay, and yeah, create project offline. Okay, so I'll just keep them as they are and click finish. So it's creating the Flutter project now. And here we see Hello World Android and the interface, but soon we'll change the Hello World Android. Let me shut down this window over here and minimize that. Okay, now come over here and select from Android project. Okay, now here we see our Hello World project, and inside this we have a lot of folders, and here inside this lib folder we see main.dart, and this is the entry point of our app. Of course, this is a dummy app, very simple app. So you can go through it and it has enough documentation. And over here, we'll click on the search icon and type in VIR. With this, we'd be able to create a virtual machine. So click here, create virtual device. And here we have a bunch of options. And for this tutorial, I'll stick to Pixel 4 Play Store. Click on this. And then I'll click next. Okay, and over here we also have a lot of system images, and we'll pick one over here. The one has with S. Okay, API level 31. So select this and click on download. So it'll download a bunch of files from Google server, and once that is done, click on finish. And now here you see the download option has gone because it's been downloaded. Click next. And here we might have a lot of other options, but we'd keep them default. Okay, you can view the advanced options, but I'm not going to click on them or change. Click finish. Okay, all right, so with this our it has been created, and click on this icon over here. And it'll launch the emulator over here right next to this main window. And this is our Android emulator. And it's pretty complete for a test device. Okay, and click on this one, the arrow button, and it will launch the app, main.dart, as you can see down there. So running Gradle task, it means it's building the application for ourselves. It may take a bit of time if you run it first time. And here we go. Here we see our application is ready. It popped up and you can click on the button. It's an interactive button. You can click on the button to add stuff. Okay, now go to this file settings options. And here we'll select, let's say, emulator. Yes, this one. And uncheck this option. With this, you can actually launch the emulator from a different window, okay? Yes, because we want to launch it separately, not from the same window. So click here, launch, okay? Now you'll see it's been launched in a separate window, okay? So it's detached right now. Yeah, so yeah, that's pretty much